Okay, I bet you clicked on this video asking yourself, am I really going to beat a dead horse and compare a 308 to 6.5 Creedmoor? And my answer to that would be, in a way, yes I am, but with a modern twist. I know we've all heard the comment that a short 6.5 Creedmoor is going to have almost identical ballistics to a longer barrel 308. So what I plan to do in this video is test that exact theory. I'm going to run my 14.5-inch 6.5 Creedmoor side by side with my 20-inch 308 on steel all the way out, hopefully to 1,000 yards and beyond, and bring you along for the journey to see how these two setups actually compare in the real world. So what's in store in this video? We're going to move down to 100 yards and show you a baseline of performance with each rifle with regards to accuracy that it produces with ammunition that will be similar between each rifle, as well as some higher BC, more efficient loads from Ally Munitions. I'll give you a look at groups as well as velocity consistency. And then from there, once we're zeroed, we'll move out and shoot steel at further distances. I want to start about 500 yards and try to push steel out at least to 1,000. And if we're making impacts, maybe even a little bit further. This will be my first time really stretching the legs on a 14.5-inch 6.5 Creedmoor. So I'm really curious to see what I get for performance. I hope you're excited. You got to let me know in the comments down below. What do you expect for a comparison between a 20-inch 308 and a 14.5-inch 6.5 Creedmoor? Are they going to be almost identical ballistically as we get out to distance, or will one of these rifles show an advantage over the other one? Let me know. I'd love to chat down below. Now, while you're leaving your thoughts below, let's talk about the gear I'm going to run in this video. I've got two rifles that I'm really excited to bring to the channel. So the first one that I'm going to be shooting right here is my SR25 or my Mark 11 Mod Zero setup. Now you'll notice this rifle, the upper, actually, I just swapped the rail on this over to the RAS. This started out life as an EMR upper. So that EMR upper would have included the correct 20-inch barrel for a Mark 11 Mod Zero. I threw it on my Mark 11 Mod 1 lower, which has the Magpul stock. It's got the Geissele SDE trigger in it, makes it a really sweet shooter. But the really cool thing that I'm excited about that allowed me to complete this package is the release of the Griffin Armament MGL line of suppressors, or military gate latch. In this case, this is the MGL 11, and this is going to be my first rounds through this new suppressor. So you'll notice this Griffin Armament suppressor is on my Knights Armament upper, and that's because it is designed to be compatible. In this case, with a Mark 11 Mod Zero, there's also the MGL 10, which is compatible with an M110 style upper. And then there's the MGLC, which is a carbine setup, which would be compatible with a 16-inch SR25 that has the correct gas block and M110 flash suppressor. So again, first rounds through this MGL 11. I am super excited because it allowed me to finally complete this upper and show it to my viewers here on the channel. I think this thing came together really well. Certainly finding some of the components like this front sight is very tough, but this thing is as correct as I can make it for a Mark 11 Mod Zero. Cannot wait to see how it shoots and bring you along for the journey. Optics, I'm running the loophole Mark 5, 5-25 on this rifle in the Badger Condition 1 mount. Now the optic was provided by Ally Munitions. They've been a huge supporter of my channel for some time now. I appreciate them for their support. And this has been a really quality scope. I shot this earlier on some videos where I shot some longer range matches there in the Southeast, performed very well. This will be one of the first times I really stretched this scope out to distance to 1,000 yards and beyond. It is equipped with a Tremor 3 reticle, which I've got a lot of experience and really enjoy shooting longer distances with. This Condition 1 mount, I certainly have the Raptor rail on top, I have the bubble level on the side, and I have the data board here on the side. So if you saw me shoot that precision rifle match back in January, the practical precision long range match, this is the exact setup that I would have used in that match. In that video, I was running a 20-inch 6.5 Creedmoor barrel in my LMT MWS. Tripod on this rifle is going to be the two vets. This one I will be shooting off of when we shoot in that 500 to 800 yard range. I love shooting off the tripods. Two vets did provide this to me for use on the channel. It's very sturdy and has worked very well with the rounds I've put through it so far. So that is the 308 that we're going to be shooting. For a 6.5 that we're going to be running, I'm going to shoot my LMT MWS. This is a rifle I've owned for a long time now, probably 12 years or more, maybe 14 actually. Factory LMT MWS, the trigger in this actually is the Ballistic Engineering Accurized AR Match Trigger. So this is a single stage trigger versus a two stage in this rifle, but this thing has very clean break, very short reset. It is a very nice trigger for precision shooting. The barrel in this is going to be an LMT 6.5 14.5-inch barrel. So this is a factory LMT barrel. I actually was able to pick this up at some point previously from one of my followers on Instagram, so I appreciate the hookup there. This thing is a sweet shooter with the right ammunition. Suppressor-wise, you can see I'm running my Surefire SOCOM 7.62 Mini. I've owned this suppressor for a long time, have a ton of rounds through it. Great suppressor for knocking the blast down. I don't expect it to be as quiet as this MGL11, but it will still knock the blast down, make it a little bit quieter, tame the recoil, tame the dust, and make the overall shooting experience quite a bit better. Optic on this rifle is going to be the Element Theos 6-36 that was provided to me by Utah Air Guns. Appreciate their support. They also provided the chronograph that I'll be using in this video, the FX True Ballistic Chronograph. Love that chronograph because it allows me to determine a true G7 BC for the rounds that I'm going to be shooting. The mount here is a Griffin Armament single piece 1.45 inch. I want to say that's got some MOA built into it, maybe 15 MOA. I can't remember off the top of my head, but it does have MOA built into it. I do have the Raptor rail on top of it, as well as the bubble level to try to keep things as identical as I can. This scope has more magnification than the loophole, so I will try to limit myself to not go above the 25 power so that we're equal. The reticle in this is a Christmas tree style reticle. It is very clean, very usable for long range shooting. It's gonna make it really easy to make those impacts out of distance. Now, for ammo that we're gonna use in the video, I have a couple of different options that we'll be shooting. For an apples to apples comparison, I want to run two different loads from Winchester. So the 308 load is going to be the Winchester Match M118 LR load equipped with the 175 SMK. So I expect this will be a good performer. I've shot a ton of this stuff previously. It groups pretty well, but I think what we're going to find is the velocity is going to be across the board on this. I expect to be able to make hits with this pretty consistently out to 800 yards, maybe a little bit further. But that has a 175 Sierra Match King. In the 6.5 Creedmoor, we're going to be running Winchester Match with the 140 grain Sierra Match King bullet. So bullet-wise, we're going to be identical. Sierra Match Kings, we're going to be running match loads, the exact same thing from Winchester. Now, this Winchester 140 grain load, you've seen this on the channel previously, and similar to the 308, my results have been hit or miss. So accuracy-wise, I'm expecting this hopefully to be 1.5 MOA or better out of this rifle, but I expect velocity kind of be across the board. Large spread, large standard deviation. I've had some challenges in the past pushing this out to distance beyond 800 yards, but we'll see what happens in this video. So that will be apples to apples comparison, same bullet, same load from the same company. Then to truly test the performance of each rifle, I have a couple of loads from Ally Munitions. For the 308, I actually have their 176 A-tip load. I've shot this on the channel previously out of a 20 inch SR25 and had great results out to 1200 yards and beyond. So this 176 grain A-tip, the Ally Munitions load, my experience has been very good. So what I plan to do with this load is run the M118 LR until I can't make consistent hits, or shoot the same target and then swap to this and see what happens to my performance. So appreciate Ally Munitions for this round. And then the other load from Ally Munitions will be their 6.5. This is a 140 grain ELDM. This load I've had great results with. This is the load that I shot in that practical precision rifle match earlier this year where I made impacts out to about 1100 yards. This is a great load as well out of a 6.5 Creedmoor. I know it shoots very well out of this 14.5-inch barrel. So again, my plan with this will be to run the 140 SMK from Winchester until I can no longer make consistent impacts. Or when I get out there maybe to 800 to 1,000 yards, run the Sierra Match King loads and then swap over to the more efficient loads. So I understand these are not the same bullet. The A-tip is a little bit more efficient than the ELDM, but I think it still will give us a view of how bullet selection really optimizes the performance of each of these calibers. So I know there's a lot of talking. From here, let's move down to 100 yards and start shooting. Out of the gate, let's take a look at the 100-yard performance of each rifle. First up, I fired the 14.5-inch 6.5 Creedmoor with the Winchester 140 grain match load. So what you'll see in the clips I'm gonna roll in here on paper, those first 10 rounds, I fired 5 on the left-hand dot, then immediately transitioned over to the center dot. No time to cool down or reposition. There was 10 rounds in the mags. I simply fired 2 5-round groups back to back. What I saw for performance, the first 5 rounds landed in a group that measured 1.1 inches, which is very acceptable. And then the next 5, I transitioned over to the center dot and I fired a group that by itself measures 2 inches. This left-hand flyer here, maybe it could have been me, maybe it could have been the ammo. This stuff is very inconsistent. So by itself, that's a 2-inch group, which really isn't that spectacular. When I stack all 10 rounds together, which I did with the dots here, that measures 2.2 inches overall. So a 2 MOA load out of that rifle, really not that impressive. What did we see for velocity performance out of that 140 grain match ammunition? Well, here's our numbers, excuse my handwriting. The average on the 10 rounds was 24.93, which really isn't bad for a 14 and a half inch barrel. Extreme spread of 106, which is huge, very inconsistent. SD of 29, again, that is huge, and I'm really not that impressed. And the BC that the FX True Ballistic Chronograph figured is a G7 of 0.272. Prior to this video, I didn't look up what 140 SMK G7 BC is. I'm just gonna run with this 0.272 that was measured out of the chronograph and see how it performs. Now, unfortunately, due to the accuracy here and the wide range of velocity, I'm not expecting great performance out of this 140 grain match load from Winchester out to distance. I've shot this on the channel before and haven't really been that impressed, but I've got a bunch of this stuff, so I'm gonna go ahead and shoot it at the closer ranges. Then I fired 5 rounds of the Ally Munitions 140 grain ELD M load, and I'm much happier with that performance. So this group measures 1.1 inches overall, 4 of them stacked together, one flew a little bit out. Could have been me, could have been the Mirage. Pretty tough conditions here at 100 yards. Velocity performance I'm much happier with, so an average of 25-26, extreme spread of 25, SD of 8.4, so single digits, and a measured BC of 0.318 for a G7. Again, I didn't look that up prior to this video, so I'm just gonna shoot that when we get out there to those further distances. So my plan with the 14 and a half inch, I likely will run this 140 load maybe out to about 800 yards. And if we push further, I'm gonna swap over to the 140 ELDM just because it's shooting much more consistently. Then after shooting my 6.5, I swapped over to the 308 20 inch barrel and fired the group shown here. So again, out of the gate, I started with 10 rounds of the Winchester M118LR 175 grain load. So my first 5 rounds landed here on the left-hand dot. This was my first round up top, and then the next 4 stacked into here. Overall, this group measures 1.3 inches, which I'm okay with, especially given this first round was a flyer. Could have been me. That was a cold rifle, cold bore. Then I immediately swapped over. Again, I had 10 rounds in the magazine, so I just shot 5 and then transitioned over to the center and fired these 5 rounds right here, which is unbelievable, 0.75 inches. When you look at this group and these 4, those all stack in there together. So really those last 9 shots well into an inch or under an inch. This group by itself measures 0.75 inches, which I'm really happy with. If you stack these 5 and these 5 into a 10 round group, I'm gonna call that about 1.5 inch because it did open it up just a little bit here on the low end. For velocity performance, not great, but definitely better than the 140 grain 6.5 load for Winchester. So an average of 25-46, an extreme spread of 54, which is pretty huge, an SD of 16, which is pretty large, and a calculated G7 BC on that 175 SMK of 0.252. Then I swapped over because I wanted to see what my Ally 176 A-tip load would do, and I fired these 5 rounds here, which measure 1.5 inches across, and that is horizontal spread. That's likely me, the shooter. There was, again, a lot of Mirage when I shot these groups, so maybe I could tighten that up. It seems like this one flew a little bit outside of the group. That likely was me, but it measures 1.5 inches. Velocity-wise, I'm much happier. So an average of 25.43, so almost identical. Extreme spread of 27, much better. SD of 9, so single digits, much better. And a calculated G7 BC on that 176 A-tip of 0.295. Somebody in the comments will have to fact check what this actually is, published from Hornady. But again, I didn't look it up. My plan is just to shoot this load. Again, I'll probably run this one out there past, say, 800, because it's a little bit more consistent than the M118LR. So there's a look at your 100-yard performance. Now let's push out on steel and see how those two different calibers and different barrel lengths actually perform out to distance. I ran down and put up a couple of steel targets out there. The first one is a 12-inch circle that ranges at 490 yards. And then the second is a 2/3 Zipsic that ranges out there at 750. So let's start with the 14 and a half inch 6.5 Creedmoor shooting the Winchester 140 grain match load. That target at 490, my shooter app is calling for 3.3 mils, so I'll go ahead and dial that on. I do have a bit of windage, probably from about the, I don't know, say 5 o'clock. My wind flag is pushing straight back, so let's just go dead on with the first round.
So that went over it probably 3/10. So I just went down 3. One has looked good. Impact on the right edge. Impact. Not sure what that was. Impact. So it seems like 3 mils is a solution, holding about a half left. Now let's go out to that 2/3 zipstick at 750. My app was calling for 6.8, but I'm only gonna dial 6.5, given what I just saw there at 490. And I'm gonna hold that same, let's call it a half left. Up a couple more there, 750. And I'll start with that same half left. So out there at 750, it seems like I'm at 6.6 mils of elevation, and I'm roughly 0.3 to 0.5 left of the target to get those impacts. So really no problem connecting out there. Let's swap over to the 308. Here we go with the 308. First up is the 12-inch circle at 490, and then we'll swap over to the 2/3 zipstick at 750. My shooter app is calling for 3.2 mils to 790 with this rifle. And wind conditions are very much similar. And I have that here at the shooting position, kind of 5 o'clock wind. Remember the Creedmoor, we were kind of holding left by about a half mil. Tell you what, I'm not coming off the plate. Impact right where I was aiming. So I'd call 3.2 to 490 pretty good. Pretty much dead on. Now let's go find that 2/3 zipstick at 750. My shooter app was calling for 6.8. Put that on. And our impacts were pretty centered up. Wind flag is pushing pretty much straight back. Let's go with a dead hold. Drop a little bit low. Same hold. Actually, let me come up 2/10. That went over it. Back down the 2/10. And the shoulder on the right, come down 1/10. Favor left edge. Tap. 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 I believe that last one was a miss, but seems like 6.7 mils out there to 750, and I'm favoring kind of left edge with this 308. So far, very similar results. How about we really stretch the legs on these rigs? I have a full-size Ipsic out there at 1,035 yards, and let's start with the 308. First up, I'm gonna use the Winchester 140 grain match ammunition to see how it performs. Now, the BC that I determined at 100 yards, I programmed that into my shooter app, and it's calling for 11.8 mils of elevation to get out there, so I'll go ahead and dial that on. And we're looking at one of my targets, the closer one for sure. I'm gonna go ahead and run the chronograph as well so that we can watch what the velocities do while we shoot. So, man, the wind, it feels very calm. So let's just hold dead on. We'll hold dead on with both rifles to start. Off the right edge. Let's come left. Call it 4 to 5 tenths. Alright, so that dropped low. Windage looked pretty good. Let's bring it up 4 tenths. And shoot that same .4 left. Way low. That's another half low. Let's come up 3 tenths. Just off the right edge, so I need to bump left to like 0.8. Over it. Shot was fast at 2611, so we have a spread pushing 100 feet per second again. In fact, seemed like on the left edge, upper left shoulder, so let me come down. Just off that right edge. And that went over it. The tough course of fire. We're up here at 12.2. We had 3 impacts. But our spread was 94 feet per second with an SD of 25. That's pretty tough shooting. Let's try the 176 A-tips. I swapped over to the Ally 176 A-tip load, which had much more consistent velocity at 100 yards. My shooter app is calling for 10.9 mils of elevation. But remember, my 176s were landing about 0.2 to 0.3 high. So I'm gonna go ahead and only dial 10.7 to try to take out that point of impact difference that we had at 100 yards. Now, let's see what we can do with the 176 A-tip. I've adjusted my chronograph to watch them run. So here we go. Now we were left, call it a half. I'm gonna start left 4 tenths. Pretty much right where I was aiming. Let me come up a tenth. And we'll hold dead on. couldn't tell what that one was. It looked like it hit the dirt, but you can already see right there, those 176 A tips are way more consistent. And I am at, call it 10.8 dialed plus probably 2/10. So call it 11 mils. And we're just a little bit left edge of target. Let's push out further with this 308. I forgot to add the velocity information on the 176 A tips. I fired 7 rounds and I had a average speed of 25.47 with a velocity spread of 14 and a standard deviation of 4.7. I can see we shot a beautiful group down there. That is really good performance for this bullet. So next up, we'll shoot the 14.5 inch 6.5 at the full size Zipsic there at 1,035 yards. I'm gonna start with the Winchester 140 grain match ammunition, and my shooter app calls for 11.8 mils to get out there. So almost identical to the 308 175. So we'll go ahead and give this a go. Now it's been probably 15 minutes since I shot the 308. Let's just start dead on and see what happens. Remember the 308, we were making impacts out there at about a half mil left. So just dead on. All right, so that was pretty far over there, but say 1.2. Elevation looked good. Just off that right edge. So 1.5. Impact. Look on the right edge. Let's go like 1.7. That dropped just off the left, so 1.5. Low. Speed seemed decent. Windage was good. That. 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 That was a really good run with the 140 SMK. Elevation wise, we are at 11.8 and I was about 1.5 left to make those impacts. Now I'll swap over to the 140 ELDM from Ally Munitions, see how it performs. So an update on the velocity. Those 10 rounds of 140 SMK were average of 24.70. Spread was only 34 feet per second on that one. So that's pretty solid, standard deviation of 11. That actually is much better than the Winchester 308 that we shot. And it's showing a G7BC of 0.284. So pretty decent performance for velocity on that run. So I swapped over to the 140 ELDM load from Ally Munitions. My shooter app is calling for 10.6 mils of elevation to get out there, but I'm gonna dial up to 10.7. If you remember, at 100 yards, the ELDM was impacting about 0.1 to 0.2 low. So I'll go ahead and dial that in to account for that slight difference in point of impact. So from here, full size Zipsic at 1035. And remember, we were making our hits out there at 1.5 with the SMK. Maybe let's just start there and see what it looks like. All right, so that actually landed over there at about 2 mils. I'm going to come down 2/10 and go 1.6, 0.7. That. That. Off the left edge. Right edge, 1.6. soft edge. Back. All right, let's call that good. So, that was my last round anyway. So quite a few impacts out there, 1,035 using the Ally 140. And I am at 10.5 dialed on. Let's move on out to a full-size Ipsic, 1,275 yards with my 308. According to my shooter app, that's going to require 16.1 mils of elevation to get out there with the 176 8-tip. And I'm going to go ahead and dial that on. Now, we were just impacting out there at 10.35, holding pretty much left edge of plate. So my plan here will be probably to do the same. According to my shooter app, this bullet's going to be going transonic right in this area. I'll start left a half. And right beside, right where I was aimed, huh? So let's go left 2/10. I'm going to come up a 10th. Here we go, left edge. Impact. That's awesome. Can't see it on the plate, but keep going. Dropped a little bit low. Let's come up another 2/10. Windows look good. That. That might have been a, well, I heard it hit. Must have hit right on the edge and glanced off. All right, so that dropped right there at about 2/10. Left edge, dead on the plate. Missed it. So we had quite a few impacts out there. I think 3 or 4, depending on what that one that might have hit the edge of the plate was. Velocity performance was beautiful out of that 176 A-tip. Average 25.57, extreme spread of 25, standard deviation of 6.5. And I am at 16.5 mils to get out there to make those impacts. So pretty cool to be able to connect with a 20-inch 308 at 1,275 yards. The key is good ammo. Let's see what this little 14.5-inch 6.5 is capable of. Full-size Ipsic, 1,275 yards, 140 grain ELDM from Ally Munitions. My shooter app is calling for 15.4 mils. I'm gonna go ahead and dial on 15.5 to make up for the 10th there at 100 yards. That was different versus where I'm zeroed with the 140 SMK. Let's get, if you're curious, there's 36 power. But I'm gonna dial that back. It's too much zoom for me. I did shoot this course of fire with the other scope at 25 power, so we'll put it there. Now we were making our impacts at what, like 1.5? Let's just start there. Just off that left edge. Beautiful. Let's go. 1.3. Looks like that dropped low left. Let me come up a 10th. Hard to see in that mirage. Let's go over to 1. That definitely dropped low. Come up 2/10, 3/10.
One mil looked good. Seems pretty dialed at 1 mil left. That Hornady light flashes a while. Yeah, held too much wind. Let me go back to one. Off the right edge. Let's land on a hit for the last round. Ugh. Off the, well, I think that was a miss. So we are at 15.9 mils of elevation, velocity beautiful. So average of 25.15 or 25.19, spread of 20, and a standard deviation of 7, which is really great performance. And again, it's calculated an average BC of 0.318. So I'd love to hear what Hornady actually publishes for this bullet. Seemed like we got quite a few impacts out there from here. Let's go ahead and summarize my thoughts on a short 6.5 versus a 20-inch 308.
There we have it, a side-by-side comparison of a 14.5-inch 6.5 Creedmoor with a 20-inch 308 at 1,275 yards. You gotta let me know in the comments down below, what did you think about the performance of each caliber? Were you impressed by one? Did one stick out as a clear winner? Or do you think they're pretty equally matched? While you're doing that, I'll chat about my experience running each of these calibers side-by-side. Now I understand some of the variables are different. We have different optics on these rifles, we have different suppressors, we had different bullets in a couple of the examples. Now while there are some differences in variables, I do believe we did capture some really good information that we can truly understand how a shorter 6.5 Creedmoor is going to stack up with a longer 308 regardless of how they're equipped. Now, what did we see for performance? At 100 yards, first thing we did was fire, accuracy, and velocity test. The M118 LR load out of the 20-inch SR25 seems to be a 1 to 1.5-inch shooter. We had that first round of the 10-round string that flew a little bit high, making the group 1.5 inches overall. The next 9 went into a group that was about maybe 1 inch. So great accuracy out of the M118 LR load. Velocity-wise, we averaged about 25-45, but we had a pretty large extreme spread of roughly 55 feet per second. So that is quite a bit. That's more than I would like to see out of a match load. I then swapped over and fired 5 rounds of the 176 A-tip from Ally Munitions, and those 5 rounds went into a group that was about 1.5 inches. There was a horizontal spread there. Could have been me. Could have been Mirage. It is what it is. Much better velocity performance out of the Ally load, so an average of about 25-45, but extreme spread less than 30. Beautiful SD, but a much higher G7 BC. So while velocities are the same, with a higher G7 BC, we're going to see better performance down range. It's going to be flatter shooting. It's going to fight the wind a little bit better, and I believe we saw that in the video. Out of the 6.5 Creedmoor, we fired 10 rounds of the 140 SMK from Winchester, and those 10 rounds were decent performance. The first 5 went into a group that was about 1.1 inches. The next 5 went into a group that was about 2 inches overall. One of those flew low left. When you look at the 10 total, it was about a 2.2 inch group, so not great performance. If you remove the one flyer that flew low left, it was about 1.5 inches, which is decent. Velocity-wise, those 10 rounds averaged 24.90, but they had a huge extreme spread of roughly 100 feet per second. That is really not good, not impressive. A very high standard deviation, pushing 30 feet per second, and a decent G7 BC. So the G7 BC on the 140 SMK was about 0.272, if I remember correctly, which is a little bit higher than the 175 SMK, which measured 0.252 on the same chronograph. So while the speed was slower, the higher G7 BC, in theory, should maybe make it a little bit more efficient, flatter shooting. I then swapped over and fired 5 rounds of the 140 ELDM load from Ally Munitions, and those 5 rounds went into a group that was about 1.1 inches. Velocity averaged about 25.20, so a little bit faster, and a higher G7 BC of 0.318. So a faster bullet, higher G7 BC means it's going to perform better at long range. Flatter shooting is going to stay supersonic longer. It's going to make it easier to make those impacts. So overall, decent performance accuracy wise. It definitely likes that 140 ELDM load much better than the 140 SMK, but the 140 SMK shot decently throughout the video. From there, we pushed out and we shot steel. First up was a 12-inch plate at 490 yards. We saw no problem making impacts with either rifle, and what I saw for elevation difference using the same Sierra Match King bullet there was an advantage of about 0.2 mils to the 6.5 Creedmoor. So about 0.2 mils flatter, which is less than one MOA difference at 490 yards. Windage, if I remember correctly, was about the same, nothing extreme, favoring left to make those impacts. Then I pushed out on a 2/3 Zipsic at 750 yards. And again, we saw a slight advantage to the 6.5 Creedmoor of about 0.2 to 0.3 mils flatter. Again, windage was similar. I believe I was favoring left with both rounds, but nothing extreme. Really had no problems connecting on that 2/3 Zipsic off of the different tripods, whether I was shooting off of the Ultradyne or off of the Two Vets tripod. Then we pushed out on a full-size Zipsic at 1,035 yards, and this is where we saw quite a bit of difference in performance. At 1,035 yards, I fired the 308 with the M118LR first. I struggled to make impacts. I only connected 3 out of 10 times out there at 1,035 at 12.4 mils of elevation. I was getting a lot of rounds around the plate, but the consistency was really a challenge with the M118LR. I swapped over to the 176 A-tip, and we had beautiful performance. I only fired 7 rounds because I was making so many impacts, and there I was at 10.8 mils of elevation. So while initial velocities were pretty much the same, the G7BC advantage of the 176 A-tip really showed up at 1,035. Hit percentage was higher, and it was much flatter shooting, 1.5 mils roughly flatter shooting. The 6.5 Creedmoor at 1,035 yards, great performance. The 140 SMK, I believe I was at about 11.6 to 11.7 mils where I made a ton of impacts actually. I was very surprised at the number of impacts that I made with the 140 SMK. I ran the chronograph and I saw much lower extreme spread on the velocities of the 140 SMK on the 1,000-yard string. And that kind of consistency allowed me to connect many times. That was about 11.6, 11.7 mils. So roughly 0.6 to 0.7 mils flatter than the 308 with the same bullet. Then I swapped over to the 140 ELDM load from Ally Munitions, and we saw great performance with it. Very high hit percent, bucked the wind maybe a little bit better, and it was flatter shooting. So the 140 ELDM load at 1,035, I was connecting at 10.8 mils, really without any trouble. So no problems with a 14.5 inch 6.5 Creedmoor at 1,035 yards. Great shooting little rifle, actually, it's a ton of fun. I then pushed out on the full-size Zipsic, 1,275 yards, and this is where we saw the hit percent of both rifles drop down. Now, I only fired the higher efficiency loads from Ally Munitions at 1,275. In the case of the 308, I fired the 176 A-tip. I connected 4 out of 10 times. One of those was a glance off the right, but it was an impact on the plate. I think you saw that in the video. I made those impacts at about 16.4 mils, so a lot of elevation to get out there. According to my app, we were transitioning to that transonic and subsonic zone with the 176 A-tip. Still cool to be able to shoot a rifle like this out that far and make a decent number of impacts. With the 6.5 Creedmoor, I only fired the 140 ELDM load from Ally Munitions, connected 4 out of 10 times out there, and I was at 15.4 mils. So it's about a mil flatter with the 140 ELDM, roughly the same wind hold favoring left, same hit percent, but we did it more efficiently with this rifle to the tune of 1 mil flatter. So ultimately, we saw this 14.5 inch rifle consistent out to 1,035 on a realistic type target, had a decent number of impacts out there at 1,275 with this rifle. I'd argue we saw very much similar performance with the 308 when I was running that high efficiency 176 A-tip. So ultimately, in my opinion, with the Sierra Match King, we saw both rifles be very equally matched in my opinion. Slight advantage, the 6.5 Creedmoor all the way out to 1,035 where I quit shooting the Sierra Match King. Slight advantage, the hit percent on the 6.5 Creedmoor, but ultimately drop really wasn't that far off out to 750. And when we got out there to 1,035, it was only about 0.6 to 0.7 mils. So not as drastic maybe as I was expecting. When you look at the higher efficiency A-tip bullet from the 308 and the 140 ELDM, we did see equal performance of 10.8 mils out there at 1,035. But you have to remember the A-tip is a more efficient bullet than the ELDM. So had I been shooting an A-tip out of the 6.5 Creedmoor, I suspect we would have seen that even flatter shooting. So the advantage for the 6.5 Creedmoor would have grown had I been apples to apples. In this case, I used a slightly lower efficiency ELDM to equal the 176 A-tip at 1,035. When we pushed out there to 1,275, we saw the lower efficiency ELDM have an advantage to the tune of roughly 1 mil versus the high efficiency 176 A-tip. So ultimately, my opinion, these are both very equally matched. You can really optimize your 308 with your bullet choice. In this case, that 176 A-tip from Ally Munitions is a great choice. It's a great performer, had great luck out there at 1,035 and 1,275. Now, shooting these rifles, to me, there's not a ton of difference. Slight recoil advantage to the 6.5 Creedmoor. You'll have to let me know in the comments, what did you see in the scope camera for movement out of the rifle under recoil? From a prone position, you get behind this rifle with a proper position, it really doesn't move around that much. And I think you saw that in video. Really not that hard to make your follow-up impacts with a 308 when you have the proper position. Even off the tripod, this rifle was very manageable. Ultimately, to me, the 6.5 Creedmoor is going to be a little bit easier to shoot. You don't have to fight it as much. You don't have to work through the recoil as much to make those follow-up impacts. It's just easier on your shoulder. Maybe doesn't move around as much. Again, let me know what you saw in the comments. Now, as far as how these rifles are set up and configured, again, I understand these are not apples to apples, different optics, different suppressors. But if you look at what we have here, we have a shorter, much more manageable rifle with the same performance of a much longer, likely slightly heavier rifle. So it is really cool to see a short 6.5 Creedmoor and the efficiency advantages it has out of a package like this. We all know if you extend the barrel out, you go 20 inches or 22 inches, this thing's gonna be a laser. It's gonna dominate this longer barrel 308. But this is a rifle that we've all known and likely loved for a long time now. And here we come with a shorter 6.5 Creedmoor and equal the performance with the advantage of lower recoil, better wind, maybe flatter shooting with the right bullet. This thing is just really maneuverable, easy to shoot around. Like if we had a lighter weight scope on this, you could maybe run and gun, some closer range type stuff. But then as we showed out here today, you can really stretch this out to distance, no problem. So ultimately, I know this is a long video. If you made it this far, I appreciate you sticking around, appreciate your support. I'd like to ask you to help me grow this channel. It's really easy. Like this video, comment down below what you thought. Best of all would be subscribe so you're in line for my next video drop. Don't forget to check me out on Instagram. I'm always trying to engage with each of you, give you a sneak peek of what I'm working on there. So thanks for watching. Hope you'll join me in my next video.